Table. We've got Kumar Bhatendra Singh, Lok Sabha MP of the BJP here in the studio with us. Sachin Pilot stays with us from Jaipur tonight. Mr. Singh, would you concede that there is pressure today that the party faces on this bill, that it just wasn't thought through when this ordinance was pushed?
No, I don't agree. It was very much thought through. It's an old ordinance that the UP had got. So it's really, that ordinance was not good for the farmer, not good for the industrialist. So we were, you know, it was a promise that we would make. Development was our main agenda. So how do we make possible? For example, I'm from West UP, so on the one hand, I'm very worried about the farmers should get proper compensation and they should be consulted. But on the other hand, I want a high court bench, I want an airport. And for that, we have to have land acquisition. I want highways.
You're toning down your position because you have opposition from now within your Sangh affiliates like the Bharatiya Kisan Sangh. You have the NDA allies who have raised objections to it. Have you come under pressure from that kind of opposition today?
No, this type of opposition is always there. It's a democratic party with democratic allies. So we expect discussion. It's a democratic process and the Prime Minister is welcoming it. He's asking everybody to please take part in the discussion, not walk out like the Congress did today. First they jumped into the well, then they walked out. So this just hampers the whole democratic process and the proceedings of the Lok Sabha.
So it's Sachin Pilot, when there are differences and when there's pressure, it's now called a democratic process, which is why you'd be a good spokesperson for the party. But Sachin Pilot, the Congress clearly seems to have made up its mind that it's not going to back down on the issue of the land bill. But the Prime Minister has also said that he's willing to talk to parties one more time to get you all to see the BJP's point of view on this.
You see, Nidhi, first of all, this act replaced a 100-year-old law. And it was done not in haste, it was done after years of deliberation. And the Standing Committee of Parliament, which is headed by a BJP MP, after two long years, gave many amendments, suggestions, and finally when the bill was passed, it was done with unanimity. And the BJP stood for the act as it was passed. Now today, 7 months, 8 months have gone by. Suddenly they realize that they need to help the friends who probably put the resources for the victory in the elections. And there is a reason why this government is suddenly seen as an anti-farmer government. It's not just the Congress party. It is, like you said, within the NDA, allies of the NDA, such as Shiv Sena and Akali Dal, etc. But also the RSS, the Kisan Sangh of the RSS is opposed to this because they know the facts of the matter on the ground. Across India, the amendments they want to bring will take the soul out of the act. We all want industrialization, we all want factories to come up, but not at the cost of ruining the lives of millions, hundreds of millions of farmers. And this act really is something that is going to give some support to the farming community. But look at the politics of it. Now, the government brought in ordinance after ordinance, it became a government of ordinances, and today, it is a nationwide issue where thousands of farmers are on the street, not just the Congress party. We are doing our bit as a principal opposition party, but across the nation, there is a huge uproar on why and what are the intentions of the government to do this. The same law was okay 7 months ago. And when you come to power, what are the reasons? No one has explained that. And mind you, even in Haryana, where they have a government, the compensation is just two times, not four times. So they're trying to give as less money as possible, take away fertile land and feed into the hands of few.
So has the BJP
Have you got spooked
with this anti-farmer tag?
No, not at all.
That seemed to be enveloping the party.
Not at all. The thing is that in June 2014, there was a meeting of all chief ministers. All 32 union territories and chief ministers were invited. And of them, most of them, said that this act that has been passed by the UPA is completely useless. It's just not benefiting. It's land acquisition for highways, for airports, and for other infrastructural projects is becoming impossible. Secondly, this is certainly not open for private. It is only for public use and public good. The land is only going to be acquired by the government and not given out to profit-making institutes or institutions, so that we are very clear about. But Maharashtra, with the Congress government, reduced the land price from 4 that the central government had promised to 2.2.
But the point is that now you're having a rethink because you're facing opposition from within.
No, it's a democratic process. It needs discussion. We are welcoming discussion.
So
the Prime Minister has said that he wants discussion.
Then the ordinance was rushed through.
It wasn't rushed through. It's how else do
because
you...
Because before the ordinance, shouldn't that debate have been in Parliament on what the... If there were changes that were needed, shouldn't that have been the debate on the floor of the House?
No, the we've got the ordinance and now the ordinance is going to be made into an act. It's coming onto the floor of the House. From the day the ordinance was made to date, there is no acquisition that has happened. So it is just a process. It's the wish of the government if they wish to bring in an ordinance first and then introduce it into the parliament, or whether they want to introduce a bill first and then make it into a law.
Sachin, you know, there was actually a lot of genuine criticism of the UPA's land bill, of course, which the BJP did support at that time. So it does have it hasn't really been able to effectively explain its various U-turns on this. But there has been genuine criticism that it really did tie the hands of the government when or of industry. When it comes to development, I mean, for instance, the five-year clause, which has been so controversial, I think Arun Jaitley, made a very strong defense of that, saying there's so many big projects that can't be completed in that 5 years. And you have to be realistic about these things. So, when this land bill, if in whatever form it does go through, does it need to find a better way to balance out the concerns of development and farmers and rather than on the two extremes it seems to be at right now?
You see, we all understand when a factory has to come up, it has to come up on land. It can't be made in midair. Now, no one is against airports, highways, railways, factories, industries coming up. There's absolutely no issue. But the problem is that all these nice thoughts are coming once the ordinance has already been passed. There was no discussion at that point. The other thing is that my fellow commentator on your program says that, it is only for certain projects. Now, when you change the definition of PPP, public-private partnership, that could mean anything. And I'm not even against some other projects coming up. But must you take away the consent clause? Must you take away the fact that the farmer has a right to go to court? Because if you acquire land of a particular individual, in this new ordinance, you have to have the permission of the government to go to court. There's no legal recourse. And this is a draconian law made by the British 100 years ago. I'm not against industrialization, about investments, we have to do it. But why take fertile ground? Why take land that is next to rivers and canals? Why not notify certain lands that are going to be for agriculture only? And the fact is that in 1 year, this act has not really been implemented. If it didn't work for a year or two, you can make amendments to it. But without seeing the impact of the act, in 7 months, you want to change it, whereas 7 months ago, you're very happy with it. Now, what has changed in 7 months? The Treasury bench has come to the opposition and you become the Treasury bench. Now, what are the incentives for that change? It can't just be they had this much knowledge about investments getting locked up 8 months ago when they passed the law, along with the Congress party, unanimously, all parties. So rethink must also be done collectively. Anyway, they will face opposition in Parliament on the streets of this country, and the Congress party and all of us will make sure that they don't take away the right of the farmer and the fair compensation that is due to them.
Okay, but Mr.
Nobody is taking away
what changed in the 7 months? I mean, seriously.
What changed in the 7 months?
I've asked every BJP spokesperson that question. What changed in 7 months?
What changed in the 7 months was that there's been a healthy dialogue, no matter which government is in Kerala or in Maharashtra, which was there. And it's the previous governments that were Congress governments that blew apart this law in their own states. So this issue needed to be addressed, and that is what has changed. And keeping that in mind, nobody is questioning the compensation of the farmers. It's just streamlining the whole process of acquisition. As far as questioning and taking the government officer to the court, it still exists. The only difference is that there is already a law to do that. If a government officer takes a wrong decision, there exists a law by which you can challenge him and take him to court. So we don't need to put it in the Land Acquisition Act. There are 13 other things that was put under another law, all separate laws, about tramways, about railways. So all that has been put under one umbrella now.
It is very obvious now with the committee that's been set up, the various consultations that are going on, that there's certainly going to be some changes to this act because there is political pressure on the BJP to do that. How do you then address the constituency of yours that has been pushing for reform, that's been pushing for this bill, which is industry? And what is the signal you believe that will send?
No, it's a democratic process. The Prime Minister has said that he wants everybody on board. He has just today, from 32% from the central budget pool, the states are going to get 42%. So he wants it, he wants a federal democratic system to work. So we want all the states to work together for development. And anyway, the land is a state issue. And so they will dominate it. It's the state governments that are going to dominate it. It's the state governments who have to acquire the land.
But Sachin, there is one, before I take last comments from both of you, there's also a valid point that some of the Congress's own leaders and chief ministers did express concerns with your version of the bill also, and they really did feel that it was just not possible to get projects moving fast enough. You've had your own share of differences within your party on this.
No, Nidhi, I understand if a certain state has issued but a project or two projects, we could have discussed that, made amendments with the discussion in Parliament. The issue is that you have already made an ordinance and issued the orders and now coming to Parliament, basically bypassing Parliament. What we did for 3.5-4 years was to convince everybody in Parliament.
We want a discussion.
You should have actually come to Parliament with a new amendment.
When you pass an ordinance, there's no discussion.
It basically means that you're doing it. And, ordinance is passed only in dire emergencies. That's what the president says, and that has been the history. Nevertheless, I think the fact is now the BJP, including I'm in Rajasthan here, the BJP-affiliated Kisan Mahapanchayat has opposed it. The RSS Kisan Sangh is opposing it. The Shiv Sena is opposing it. Now, what are the reasons that it's not healthy democratic discussion? There are repercussions on the ground, politically and otherwise, that the BJP has to face up to. That is why this new committee has been formed. And before long, they will have to come to a position where the interest of the farmers is not wished away just because the ordinance has been issued. And that we'll make sure that the Indian Parliament does that.
All right, I have to leave it at that. Gentlemen, thank you for joining us. And I believe we're also hearing that the Congress party's senior leadership is in fact planning to hold a protest on this at Jantar Mantar tomorrow. So Jantar Mantar clearly has become the site of these protests against this land bill in its current form. Anna Hazare held a two-day protest that ended today. Thank you to both of you for joining us. More on that story and much more tomorrow night. To see you then. Goodbye.